tell you about Marv Woodman and seeing how he solves cases here at, in the Gatesville Police Department, and how he brings people to justice. He's been a tremendous asset to us up here in forensics, and we're going to miss him when he's gone. I started paying more attention to Mark and how he processed crime scenes. And sure enough, he came up to forensics, and he's been a role model for most of us in how to treat crime scenes since then. It's been a pleasure working with you, Mark. I hope to call you sometime in the future to help out, but I understand if you turn your phone off. Enjoy your retirement and have a good time.
What awkward position with her left arm folded up underneath her body?
At first glance, there was no trauma to the body. No bruises, no wounds, no blood.
We had no indication of what would have caused her death.
There was a half-full bottle of beer next to Michelle's body. Only Michelle's fingerprints were on the bottle.
There was no indication that she had gotten drunk off the one beer that was lying on the bed. There was other beer in the refrigerator. There was just nothing to indicate that she had passed out drunk.
We went over to where the trash bins for that particular little community are stored. And on the ground, in a small plastic bag, I could see what was visible was a bottle, a pharmaceutical bottle. And I called the investigator over and said, "We got to look at this."
The bag contained two vials of a drug labeled propofol, some syringes, and a pediatric butterfly IV. The items were dusted for fingerprints, but none were found. Detective Mark Woodmansey came up with an idea that changed the course of the investigation. He told analysts to test the syringe caps found in Michelle's trash.
I can remember seeing medical staff hold needle caps in their mouth while they were giving an injection, and I thought that there was a potential there for saliva DNA.
I thought that was rather brilliant.
There's no way that the administration of propofol to Michelle Herndon was an accidental death. This was an action consistent with homicide.
The jury didn't believe it either. O'Quinn was convicted of first-degree murder and sentenced to life in prison without parole.
I've never had a case where the small things mattered so much. Where something as small as a needle mark or the amount of DNA left on a needle cap played such a pivotal role in the resolution of the case.
Well, here she is. They left her under an overpass for the night.
Did you find anything?
Yeah, we found a lot of stuff. From bodily fluid and hair samples, we determined that a bunch of old homeless dudes had an orgy in the car.
Oh, God.
Yeah. You know what that's called when they do that in there? It's called a soup kitchen.
It's pretty rough stuff.
Not long after that, a mama raccoon came along and gave birth on the floor.
Oh.
Placenta blew out all over the back window there.
Jesus.
Yeah, and then to top it all off, some joker comes along, takes himself a nifty little dump in the driver's seat. I think he knew you guys were cops, because this is what I would call a spite shit.
You were able to determine all of that from the hair and fluid samples.
Oh, yeah.
What about fingerprints? You find any fingerprints?
Nope. Couldn't get a one.
Found a cell phone.
Yeah, that's mine.
Any signs of a struggle or spent shells?
No. Believe me, everybody that was in on this orgy was more than willing. In fact, they even left you a note here. Thanks for the F-Shack. Love Dirty Mike and the boys. Here's something we found. We found about a dozen unscratched lottery tickets. No fingerprints or nothing. Let me check that out. Yeah, it's a real shame. You know, I got myself a Prius. It's a hell of a machine.
My first brand new car. Never owned a new car.
Found a deer vagina.
Oh, what?
I thought it was human milk at first.